we want to find the value of the summation, where this notation here is called sigma notation or summation notation. Each value that we sum will be determined by this expression here called the summand of sine of pi times k divided by 2. Well, notice how the value of this is determined by the value of k, where k is the index variable, and we have k equals 0, so 0 is the lower limit of k, and this 5 here tells us the upper limit of k is 5, which means k will take on the values of 0 and then increase by 1 until it reaches the value of 5. So k will take on the values of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Once we find each of the values from this expression here for the different values of k, we'll then find the sum of those values. So first, notice when k is equal to 0, we'd have sine of pi times 0 divided by 2. Next, k takes on the value of 1, so we'll have plus sine of pi times 1 divided by 2, plus next k takes on the value of 2, so we'd have sine of pi times 2 divided by 2, and then plus the value when k is 3, so we'd have sine of pi times 3 divided by 2. Next k is equal to 4, so plus sine pi times 4 divided by 2, and then finally plus the value when k is 5, we'd have sine pi times 5 divided by 2. Let's first simplify our angles, then we'll determine the sine function values. So this is going to be equal to, this would be sine 0 plus sine pi over 2, plus this would just be sine pi, and then plus this would be sine 3 pi over 2, plus this would be 4 pi divided by 2, or just sine 2 pi, and finally we have sine 5 pi over 2. Now to determine these sine function values, we can either reference the unit circle or reference the graph of the basic sine function. Let's take a look at both. On the unit circle, sine theta is equal to y, so sine 0 radians is equal to 0, sine pi over 2 radians is equal to positive 1, sine pi radians is equal to 0, sine 3 pi over 2 radians is equal to negative 1, sine 2 pi radians is equal to 0, and sine 5 pi over 2 radians would be equal to positive 1. We're looking at the graph of the basic sine function. We should recognize the pattern here. Sine 0 is equal to 0, sine pi over 2 is equal to 1, sine pi is equal to 0, sine 3 pi over 2 is equal to negative 1, sine 2 pi is 0, and sine 5 pi over 2 would be equal to positive 1 again. So whether we use a unit circle or the graph of the basic sine function, this would be equal to sine 0, which is 0, plus sine pi over 2, which is 1, plus sine pi, which is 0, plus sine 3 pi over 2, which is equal to negative 1, plus sine 2 pi, which is 0, plus sine 5 pi over 2, which is equal to 1. So we have a sum of positive 1, which means the value of the summation is positive 1. I hope you found this helpful.